Terrific Engineering, How South Korea Built a Floating City by 2025, Maldives Fight Against Rising Sea.
Next year, a small floating city is expected to start rising on the ocean surface along the coast of South Korea. That city, with the capacity to hold 12,000 people, is backed by the United Nations Human Settlement Program. It's meant to serve as a test model for future real estate development. If the floating city is successful, similar platforms could be built elsewhere, including right here in the United States.
In a response to the threat posed by rising sea levels, UN Habitat, the Busan Metropolitan City of the Republic of Korea, and the blue tech company OCEANIX unveiled the world's first prototype sustainable floating city. The first segment of the project should be ready by 2025. A haven of sustainable living. The floating city, OCEANIX Busan, aims to provide breakthrough technology for coastal cities facing severe land shortages that are compounded by climatic threats. The city will serve as the world's first prototype sustainable floating city, aiming to be a flood-proof infrastructure that rises with the sea, supplying its own food, energy, and water. The floating city has six integrated systems, zero waste and circular systems, closed-loop water systems, food, net-zero energy, innovative mobility, and coastal habitat regeneration. These interconnected systems will generate 100% of the required operational energy on-site through floating and rooftop photovoltaic panels. Each neighborhood will treat and replenish its own water, reduce and recycle resources, and provide innovative urban agriculture. OCEANIX Busan is the world's first prototype of a resilient and sustainable floating community. The interconnected neighborhoods spread across 6.3 hectares that can accommodate a community of 12,000 people. Starting from a community of three platforms with 12,000 residents and visitors, it has the potential to expand to more than 20 platforms. The floating platforms are accompanied by dozens of productive outposts with photovoltaic panels and greenhouses that can expand and contract over time based on the city's needs. We are on the track of delivering OCEANIX Busan and demonstrating that floating infrastructure can create new land for coastal cities looking for sustainable ways to expand onto the ocean while adapting to sea level rise, said Philip Hoffman, CEO of OCEANIX. I take seriously our commitment to the credo, the first to the future. We join forces with UN Habitat and OCEANIX to be the first to prototype and scale this audacious idea because our common future is at stake in the face of sea level rise and its devastating impact on coastal cities, said Busan Mayor Park Hyun-jun. This is as scary as it is exciting to achieve such a feat. But living in a city that resembles the communities where people try to survive in the dystopian movie Waterworld is kind of pessimistic. Maldives floating city to cope with a rising sea. The Maldives government has unveiled plans for a floating city 10 miles from its capital, Malé, as part of plans to insure the country against rising sea levels. Designed by the Netherlands-based Dutch Docklands, the Maldives floating city project will be a collection of islands across a lagoon, with thousands of low-rise waterfront local homes equipped with jetties for boats. The designers say hotels, restaurants, boutiques, and a marina will join the residences to make it a destination in itself. In a statement, the government described it as the world's first true floating island city, a futuristic dreamscape finally poised to become reality. Construction will start in 2022, with the city set to be completed in phases over the next 5 years. The design of the floating city islands channels traditional Maldivian architecture with colorful building facades facing the sea. The press release for the project says the island barriers around the lagoon will serve as breakers down below, while sandy beaches will help stabilize and protect key structures in the development. This Maldives floating city does not require any land reclamation, therefore has a minimal impact on the coral reefs, said former Maldives President Mohamed Nasheed, now a Speaker of Parliament in the country. What's more, giant new reefs will be grown to act as water breakers. Our adaptation to climate change mustn't destroy nature, but work with it, as the Maldives floating city proposes. In the Maldives, we cannot stop the waves, but we can rise with them. It comes as meteorologists and climate scientists predict that the nation of more than 1,000 coral islands will be largely uninhabitable by 2050 as a result of rising sea levels. Over 80% of the Maldives' coral islands stand less than 1 meter above sea level, putting them at risk of being swallowed up by the ever-rising ocean surface. Sea levels are rising by around 0.13 inches, or 3.2 millimeters, each year, with the pace accelerating in recent years. In November 2021, current President Ibrahim Mohamed Solih told world leaders at the United Nations Climate Conference, the difference between 1.5 degrees and 2 degrees Celsius is a death sentence for the Maldives.